Now, from your local news leader.
We got here to the scene right after witnesses say they heard shots fired.
If you listen, you can hear the ground is very saturated from rain we've gotten in the past few days. What we know is that someone was driving by and saw a body along this road at the far end of this field behind me. But come over here with me. This is probably the worst we've seen. Right here, you can see this is just pure debris. The prison is just a block away from Jackson's home where he was flying his drone late one night, and somewhere along the way, he lost control.
At least a 3-foot path cleared around the hydrant with access to water nozzles on all sides.
Cammie, I was also out here on opening day. There were high winds and wind chill warnings, and I can tell you today is almost as bad.
The seniors have only been at the church for 5 days after 9 years of activity at the Thompson Center.
Investigators also tell us that the officers at the scene believe the standoff was a setup to ambush and kill them. We'll tell you why they think that tonight at 5. Live in Nina, Sari Soffer, Action 2 News.
Two gaping holes 4 to 6 feet wide. It's what Courtney Linnell stares up at the city center ramp she parks her car in every day.
To me, that's just not safe. I don't feel like that's a place where I should be working.
Hundreds of city center employees have to park elsewhere because of what the city center manager is calling snow removal damage. The Oshkosh City Building Inspector says the manager admits to him the company's privately contracted plowing company used a front-end loader to plow the third floor, which isn't designed to hold that type of equipment's weight.
So if you're designing that parking ramp for 2,000 pounds per square foot, and something with 5,000 pounds per square foot drives over it, that's not what it was designed for.
The city is requiring City Center to hire a private engineer to investigate the damage and other damage reported, like pooling water Courtney Linnell also shows us leaks into her first floor office every time it rains or snows.
I can see dipping and sagging in certain parts of the ceiling.
The ramp, which was built more than 40 years ago, has not been inspected in at least a decade, according to city building inspectors.
There isn't a required inspection on those types of parking structures, you know, like they have it for bridges and things like that. There'd be requirements to have those inspected.
After a brief look through today, inspectors identified no other immediate dangers in the first and second levels of the ramp.
This has been a problem ongoing. What have they been sweeping under the rug for this time is only going to come out now.
So you've got 9 lanes of traffic you actually have to watch.
9 lanes, 2 stop signs, part of an equation that cost one life Friday evening.
I mean, every time it's nervous.
At the intersection of County Road CB and Oak Ridge Road in Nina.
The past few months as I've gone through there, I've just noticed more and more traffic.
Corey Pop showed us accident records he requested from the Winnebago County Sheriff's Department, highlighting 23 crashes at that intersection in the past 3 years. One of those was Wendy Mader's mother.
A vehicle that was coming on Oak Ridge Road towards CB failed to stop at a stop sign. She broke both legs below the knee and her pelvis in 3 places.
March 1st, 3 days before the most recent crash, Pop posted an online petition to get traffic lights installed at the Nina intersection.
I just wanted to get some support behind it and turn something over to the county.
Today, there's still debris at the scene of Friday's crash. After that crash, an additional 900 people signed a petition to make this intersection safer.
The county has a traffic study scheduled there this summer.
We had a study done several years ago. It doesn't meet the traffic warrants for an improvement or a signal at that intersection.
That includes traffic volume, delays, speeds, and accident history.
It didn't meet the volume warrants, and quite honestly, it didn't meet the accident warrants.
The highway commissioner expects this summer's study to have different results due to heavier traffic and more accidents the past couple years.
I thought we were ahead of it. I thought we could get something done before something like that happened.
The soonest we may see signals at the site would be 2017. In Nina, Sari Soffer, Action 2 News. Tucked in the corner of Mr. Jiskey's classroom is one of the coolest gadgets at South Park Middle School.
It's 3D modeling software, so you can actually kind of manipulate it right on the screen.
But we'll get back to Mr. Jiskey and his 3D printer later. First,
Meet Philip.
There was a girl that had to move out of her home that had goats and chickens and ducks and all kinds of critters. And there was a picture of Philip with his feet all curled up and dried because they had frozen.
Instinctively, Vicky took Philip in. After watching a video online, Vicky reached out to Mr. Jiske to see if his 3D printer could make Philip the feet he'd lost.
Well, the initial email I thought was actually, I'm like, is this for real?
We literally were an hour away from putting him down when I got the call from Jason.
I immediately called Vicky right from class, actually. I pulled up my cell phone and called. And I said, Vicky, I said, you know, I'm making the feet right now. I said, you know, hold off.
We both cried.
It's been 6 weeks of trial and error, and much like another fairy tale, this one was too small, this one too hard. And this stuff, they're hoping it's just right.
We are now using what's called Ninja Flex, and Ninja Flex is a flexible material.
The new graciously donated material takes about 36 hours to print both feet, which have been fitted to slip onto Philip's legs. Tomorrow, Philip will try them on.
That he lives with a bunch of ducks and is happy and can run outside and swim.
Soon, Philip is headed to an animal sanctuary to do just that.
Philip and I have become pretty good friends. It's going to be sad to see him go.
A bittersweet ending to a friendship that gave Philip the footing for a fresh start. In Oshkosh, Sari Soffer, Action 2 News.
Having...
For Jody Schmidt...
Maybe you could even write, I forgot.
Teaching is a perfect match.
Children are really fun. There's like a spark in their eye.
Of all the kids at Oakfield Elementary School...
Oh, you sweet lady.
It's the spark in Natasha Fuller that changed her life.
When I see her every day, she smiles and I smile too and I give her a hug.
She's really sick and you can't tell. She's really sick. When I told my students in my classroom, they were floored.
You would never know this chatty, energetic 8-year-old was diagnosed with chronic kidney disease as a toddler.
She wants to go swimming and she can't. You know, things like that, that a lot of kids or a lot of families take for granted that she cannot do.
She recently moved in with her grandparents to get treatment in Milwaukee 3 times a week.
I have 2 more tubes right there.
In August, she was put on a list to get a kidney transplant. On average, a person waits more than 3 years to get a match.
It's like they gave me a pager and I kept it with me wherever I went. I'm waiting for it to go off. I even slept with it.
Wash up and get to lunch, okay?
It was Christmas time when Jody Schmidt realized she wanted to be that match.
I always felt like there was more in life that I should be doing.
She went through tests to find she and Natasha share a blood type and other qualities that could make a transplant successful. On Friday, she broke the news to the family.
She's a tough little girl and she deserves this. She's been through a lot.
The transplant is not scheduled yet. Natasha is still getting over an infection. But in the meantime, the 8-year-old is dreaming of life after.
I can swim, I can eat chocolate.
And preparing her own gift to Mrs. Schmidt. The two already closer than ever. In Oakfield, Sari Soffer, Action 2 News.
Thank you. Oh, cool.
Isn't that awesome?
I forgot to add a color to it.
Did you?